Hi guys, welcome back to Nursing Tips with Tammy, and today we're focusing on medication administration, specifically oral tablets. Now, what do you do when the doctor orders a dose that you don't have on the floor? In the short answer, math. But don't let that scare you. Today I'm going to show you three methods to successfully calculate the right dose for the right patient. The first method we're going to look at is ratios. Second after that is we're going to look at proportions, and then the last one is dimensional analysis. Before we get started though, there are two free quizzes in the description area of this video, so please download version number one and meet me at the board.
Great, so now we're back with our first quiz question. Patient who has ramipril, 25 milligrams ordered, and we have 50 milligram tablets available. In a ratio, we set up two sides of a value statement. On the one side, I'm putting what I know. One tab is 50 milligrams. I use a colon to separate them. And I'm going to put down how many in 25. I do a visual look at 50 to 25. What did I do? I divided by 2 to get to that answer. So I will do the same for the tablets. One tablet divided by 2 is 1/2 tablets, and that's my answer for my dosing. With proportions, we're setting up two fractions or two mathematical equations that are equal to each other. So in this case, 1 tablet over is 50 milligrams is equal to a question mark over 25 milligrams. This is known as our cross multiply. We want to get rid of the denominators. So I'm going to take 25 milligrams, multiply that by 1 tablet, and that will equal to my unknown times by 50 milligrams. Now to get rid of that 50 milligrams on the right side and isolate that question mark, I need to divide both sides by 50. So on the left-hand side of the equation, you can see 50 milligrams is crossed out, leaving just the question mark. On the right-hand side, I'm going to cross off milligrams and solve. So 25 tablets divided by 50 is equal to my mystery dose. 0.5 tablets is equal to my dose, which is the same as the ratios. With dimensional analysis, this is another problem-solving method that states you can multiply any factor or number by a 1, as it does not change the outcome. So for example, I'm going to start out with what I want to know, how many tablets. And then I'm going to put in what do I know already. Now I could write 50 milligrams over 1 tab or 1 tab over 50 milligrams. I want tabs in the numerator, so I choose this method. Dimensional analysis has us working in diagonals. So the other piece of information I have is I'm looking for a 25 milligram dose and I want to cross off milligrams. Now I'm left with tablets so I can solve. 1 tablet times by 25 divided by 50, and I'm going to show you all the steps here, is equal to 25 tab divided by 50, which equals 1/2 tablet. I end up with the exact same answer as my other two methods.
So there you go. It's pretty easy, right? But wait, what if the doctor orders a dose that doesn't match the units that I have on the floor? I'm going to have to do a conversion. So let's look at question number 5. If you need to brush up on the metric system, watch my video and come back and join us, and we're going to look at how to work through a question that requires conversions.
So this question is asking me how many cephalexin 500 milligram tablets I will be giving to my patient who has an order for 0.5 grams. So we need to put these into the same unit, so we are going to do a conversion. Now because my tablets are available in milligrams, I'm going to convert 0.5 grams into milligrams, and then I can use my ratios and proportions. So 0.5 grams times 1,000 is equal to 500 milligrams. I now know that the dose required is the same as the dose available, so I'm going to give 1 tablet. Now for proportions, because we already have the correct dose available, I'm just including the math for you to see how you would work that out. So with dimensional analysis, I'm still going to start out with what am I looking for, and that is how many tablets. So I'm going to start with that. I know that I have 1 tablet is 500 milligrams on the floor, and I want to get rid of milligrams, but I don't have anything else in my question. So I go to my conversion table and I see 1,000 milligrams is equal to 1 gram. I can then cross off the milligrams. I'm left with grams still to get rid of. Back to my question, I say I have a 0.5 gram dose, so I'm going to put that into my formula next. So multiply by 0.5 grams, the grams cross off, and I'm left with tabs, and I can go ahead and solve.
Hey, you did it, and I knew you could. Three ways to solve those pesky math problems. Now, do me a favor, comment below, let me know which is your favorite method, and subscribe. Then you'll be first in line for the next video, which is weight-based calculations. Until we're together again, make it a great day.